Welcome back to another .NET MAUI Beginner Series video. I'm James Montemagno, a product manager on the developer community team here at Microsoft. And today we are continuing our journey learning how to build native cross-platform desktop and mobile apps with .NET MAUI. Previously, we learned what .NET MAUI is and how to install .NET MAUI as well. And now what we're going to do in this video is we're going to create our very first project with .NET MAUI, and I'm going to walk through all of the important aspects of what is inside of that single project, including a bunch of different cross-platform APIs and frameworks and a bunch of great things to help you be super productive. So let's head over to my desktop and get started. When you launch Visual Studio 2022 for the first time, you'll be able to create a brand new project. Here will be all the projects inside of Visual Studio 2022 that you can build based on the workloads that you selected, but we're going to find the .NET MAUI ones by typing in .NET MAUI. And here we're going to see three different project templates. We have .NET MAUI app, we have the .NET MAUI Blazor hybrid application, and a .NET MAUI class library. The class library is really nice when you want to share classes and different elements between different .NET MAUI applications. But let's get started just with the .NET MAUI app. I'm going to go ahead and hit next, and we're going to give it a name. MAUI App 2, that sounds perfect. So I'm going to go ahead and create this, and I'm going to walk through exactly every single bit that is inside of a .NET MAUI application. All right, Visual Studio is launched. Now what we can see on the right-hand side is our Solution Explorer. Over here, we have one project, MAUI App 2, because I named it MAUI App 2. What's really great here is this gives you all of your dependencies and frameworks in a single project. That means from MAUI App 2 project, I'm deploying to Android, iOS, Mac, and Windows. Now let me walk through some of the other items that are inside of this project. The first thing that we'll see here is the platforms folder. Now this is really great because this enables us as developers to access platform-specific native APIs. There is a little bit of scaffolding code in each of them, such as your Android manifest that sort of defines different permissions and app resources, and if your application supports right to left. There's also a little bit of startup code, like the main activity, and the .NET MAUI team has done a fantastic job of minimizing this boilerplate code as much as humanly possible. But know that if you need to tweak something on the platform, you can access it right here. Now, another folder that I absolutely love is the resources folder. And inside of this are shared cross-platform resources such as fonts, images, and raw assets. Now I love this because we not only get to put all of our fonts and images into a single project here, but .NET MAUI will automatically put those into the correct places when it compiles it up for each platform. Notice that the .NET MAUI bot is an SVG. Look at it, all those paths. But when you compile up the application, it will automatically convert them into PNGs and scale them so they look great on all of your devices. We'll also note that there's some SVGs for app icon and in a foreground as well. I'll get to those in a little bit. Now, what I love here is that everything is in this one area, including our app, our shell, and our main page. Now, before I get to those, let's actually double tap on the MAUI app too. Because what I want to show you is that there are some amazing cross-platform capabilities built directly into the project system itself. First and foremost, we're doing multi-targeting. Here we have Android, iOS, and Mac. And if we're on, the Windows platform also include Windows. Here we'll note that Samsung Tizen platform is also supported from the Samsung team. And if you want to develop for Tizen devices, you can just uncomment this code and install the Tizen tooling. Now, as we scroll down, we're going to see a few other properties that are cross-platform properties, such as the application title, the identifiers, and even our version codes. What's really great about this is that you can set these in one place, and for each platform, they will automatically cascade down, so they are automatically set when you compile and deploy your application. This keeps your version codes, names, and identifiers in sync across all of your applications. There's another great resource here too, which is a supported OS version, so you can add backwards and forward compatibility. I also want to scroll down a little bit here to this item group. Now this is where those resources come in. I mentioned that there was an app resource and a foreground SVG. Those are used for our app icon and our splash screen, and those are all cross-platform and generated for us automatically. Here's where our images are coming in. Automatically, it will bring in just any image that you put in that folder, but you can also include a single SVG or PNG or JPEG and also update it as well with a base size. That's really great for SVGs. Here we're also telling it exactly where the fonts are located and also the raw assets. So if you want to, you could put fonts in multiple folders, you could specify different things, and automatically this will pick up all the fonts and all the raw assets for us. And that's it, it's very minimal, which I absolutely love. Now at the start of any application is the MAUI program. And this is sort of the scaffolding of the application. It's the main MAUI program, and the startup code calls and returns a MAUI app. This is creating a builder. And what's really nice about this is that this is a very similar pattern to ASP.NET Core. Here, it's gonna go ahead and create that builder, tell it that it's using this app, and it's gonna configure fonts. There's a lot of other things that you can configure as well, such as activity lifecycles and services in the dependency service. All right, well, what is in this app? Well, if we go into the app here, we can see that the app has some app-wide resources, and they're both the colors and the styles. And those are located in the resources folder. So here are the colors, which are all defined in our XAML right here. So we can see colors and solid brushes and different accent colors too. This is great because these are gonna be used in our styles, which is a full style set that automatically will style every single control that's built into .NET MAUI. So this means all you need to do is modify a few colors and all of the different controls will update based on what your application needs to look like. Now, you can hit this little drop-down arrow and you'll see some code behind here. We usually call this code behind and it's called XAML.cs. So every XAML.cs is associated with the XAML. And we can see here that the main page of the application is being set to the app shell. Well, what's an app shell? And I'm glad you asked. Well, an app shell specifically is an opinionated shell of your application. What's great here is that it enables content templates, which are lazily loaded when your application loads up. And here it's using a single shell piece of content, which is a page, but you can easily add flyout navigation or top and bottom tabs by just adding more items. So here I can add a tab and a tab bar, or I can add a flyout item. I can even add menu flyouts as well. It's really flexible. And it also enables URI-based navigation. So here we can see that the route of the app is set to main page. So that's gonna be my main route. Now, there's this main page, and this main page will get inflated with home. So if we tap on main page, this is XAML. It's an XML-based markup. And what we have in this application is a scroll view, one of those layouts, with a vertical stack layout inside of it. Now this is gonna go ahead and stack up some images, some labels, and some buttons here to automatically click. Now, in the code behind as well, we'll see that there is a little bit of code, which we can see automatically not only increments the count, but will automatically set the text based on the count. If it's one, it'll say clicked one time or clicked multiple times. All right, let's run this application now that we're ready. What I want to show you here is that you can, from the drop-down debug menu, select the target framework that you want to debug on: Android, iOS, Mac, and Windows. Now, Android and Windows can be deployed directly on your Windows device. And additionally, if you're using Windows 11, you can enable the Windows subsystem for Android to not even have to use an emulator at all. Use your Windows device as the device that you're debugging on for Android apps. So that's great because both Android and Windows can automatically deploy directly on your Windows 11 device. If you have Windows 10, don't worry because there's a full Android device manager. Here under Tools, we'll see Android, and then there's Device Managers as well. Now, under here, when you toggle between the framework of Android, iOS, Mac, or Windows, it will automatically update what you're deploying to. You'll also see Android emulators, local devices, simulators, and remote devices. Now, I do want to mention here that for iOS, there's two different ways of deploying the application. You can either connect remotely to a Mac and deploy and debug through a remoted simulator, or you can actually plug an iOS device directly into your Windows machine and use iOS Hot Restart to deploy directly to it if you have an Apple developer account. For Mac, you'll need to be on a Mac, so check out the documentation to deploy there. All right, let's go ahead and debug this application right here on Windows. This is gonna go ahead and debug up and compile our application, and then deploy it directly onto my Windows device. All right, now that I have it running, I snapped it right here, and you can see that I simply come in and I am clicking the button, and you can see it says clicked how many times that I have it updated. We have our .NET bot image that was converted from an SVG directly into a PNG saying hello world. Now, there's some other great functionality that's built into Visual Studio. For example, let's say I have multiple monitors and I don't want the application to overlap on top of it. I can actually come into the XAML live preview and pin it here. What's really great is that I can come in and modify the size and get that window directly inside of Visual Studio. I can still interact with it in the real window that's running, but I can see a preview of it right here. Now, what that means is that I could go ahead and open up, let's say, the main page, and I can come in and say, hello.NET MAUI. I'm gonna hit save and XAML hot reload will kick in. So now we can see it says hello.NET MAUI. I could also increase that font to 100. Now it's huge. If I bring over the application, you can see it's the application running right there. That enables me to be super duper productive. I'll also mention here that on the left-hand side, I have this live visual tree. Now this is going to show me every single piece of content inside of it. So here I have my label. Let me go ahead and pin this here. I have a vertical stack layout and I have this button. And if I tap on it, it's going to automatically direct me to that button, for example. So that is really, really nice when I'm doing this. Now, what I also want to show you, let me go ahead and minimize this over. If I bring over the application, as I hover, it automatically updates here what element I have selected. So nice little hints right there. All right, so now we've gone ahead and deployed our application to Windows, but how about Android? So here we go, I'm gonna go over to Android, and now this is gonna show me my Android emulators. If I don't have one, it'll help me create one. So I'm just gonna go ahead and hit debug. What's great here is I am debugging my application. So if I want to, I can add breakpoints and I could take advantage of the great capabilities of Visual Studio in debugging and output and watch Windows too. So now this is gonna start up my Android emulator and we're gonna get the same application, but running inside of Android. So let's give it a few seconds to start up, compile and deploy. All right, here our application is now running on Android and you can see that it's absolutely huge. So let's go ahead and fix this up. I'm gonna go over to that label. Let's put that back down to 32 and hit save. That's gonna automatically update. And of course I can click. Here, I go ahead and I actually get a breakpoint and we can see my count is 1, so I can go ahead and step through it. Let's go ahead and remove that. Awesome. So now our application is updated and I'm clicking around. Now, the other thing that's built in not only is XAML hot reload, but .NET hot reload. So here, let's go ahead and change this to actually add 10 instead of 1 every single time. You can hit save or hit this little reload button here. And we can see that I'm hitting hot reload on file save. And now when I click on this, it's increasing the counter by 10 every single time. I can not only update my XAML with hot reload, but also my code behind too. And there you have it. We just started building our very first .NET MAUI application and learn everything that's inside of the project and how to deploy it onto Android or onto Windows. Now, let's go ahead and hop over to my Mac where we can see we take the same exact project and deploy it to both iOS and macOS. And here we go. I've launched the same exact file new template over on the Mac. You can do this via the command line or Visual Studio for Mac 2022. And here we can see we have the same exact application now running on macOS and over on our iOS simulator. You can also plug your iPhone into your Mac and then of course launch the application directly onto your iOS device. The same would be true if you wanted to launch the application on an iPad application simulator or on your iPad itself. And there you go. We've not only created our very first project, but we've deployed it to 4 different operating systems, and we saw the consistent user interface that has been created. And hopefully now you have a full understanding of what is inside of a .NET MAUI application when you get started. And in fact, what we're going to do in the next video is we're going to learn how to build out a more complex user interface and handle user interaction. So stay tuned to the .NET MAUI Beginner Series.